we've initiated an unintended experiment in evolution where we'll see, you know, big changes in the ecosystems and an environment.
People take habitat, and habitat is needed by a lot of these wild animals. The bumblebees seem to be suffering the most. We have to figure out what we're going to do to keep that balance.
It seems that there's fewer Morrison bumblebees than there might have been in the past. They're an integral part of the ecosystem.
What is going to happen if we lose these bumblebees? If you're watching the flower and waiting for the bumblebee, you'll know it the minute you see it. You better take a deep breath and you better take a look at that bumblebee and, you know, think about all that it can do. A single bumblebee can pollinate over 3,000 flowers in a day.
They're kind of the poster child of pollinators. There's something about them that people really love.
My background is that I was the Project Wild state coordinator for about 20 years. I was assigned to write a wildlife express issue, and it was on bees. And so, oh boy, I had a lot of learning to do. The more I learned, I got excited about it. And, you know, now I have a bee necklace and bee socks and a bee t-shirt, and so I'm the bee lady. I'm not a biologist, but because of my passion, I want to tell everyone I know how important bumblebees are to our world.
The more we learn about systems and ecosystems, we realize more and more how connected everything is. It's important that we know some of the details so we can help support those places and keep them healthy. Pollinators perform a really important duty in our ecosystems. They move pollen around from plant to plant so that plants can reproduce.
When you think about some of the animals that we have in our mountains and maybe that you like to hunt or you like to go and take pictures of, bumblebees are one of the very few species that can fly in the higher elevation and pollinate those wildflowers that those animals that we love depend on. Similar to salmon, you take them out of the habitat and you realize how many animals depend on that one keystone species. We have four pretty diverse habitats, and again, bumblebees fit in all of them.
Everything we're doing this year was focused on Morrison bumblebee. We're looking to see where they exist and what kind of plants they like. We'll hopefully be able to use that information to benefit them in the future.
We're focusing on sites that have confirmed Morrison sightings in the past, and then looking in the surrounding area where those populations could be.
A lot of the data or information that we have on bumblebees comes from citizen scientist projects.
What got me interested in these things is I did a lot of mountain hiking, and I noticed that the Xerxes Society had set up a citizen science program for people to go out and photograph bumblebees and make surveys.
Bernie, he was a physicist for his entire career, and now he's out there looking for bumblebees and really interested in Morrison bumblebee, which is really cool.
Most people will do their surveys at their favorite vacation spots up in the mountains. So I thought an interesting thing to do would be to search around in the deserts of Idaho. I'm busy trying to figure out how they make a living out here. The Morrison bumblebees are this nice golden yellow color. In a sense, it's like looking for gold.
Even if you don't have a lot of interactions with bumblebees or the desert, whether you know it or not, it is impacting you.
One out of three bites of our food depends on a pollinator.
One of the methods by which they pollinate is by buzz pollination.
And no other bees do that, where they use their jaws to bite down on the plant, and then they vibrate their wings.
And shake pollen out of flowers, and there are certain flowers that can only be pollinated that way, and those include tomatoes, peppers. So they're very important for pollinating a lot of the things we buy in the grocery store.
Yeah, that one's definitely a Morrison. We've probably done over 50 sites. This is the second site that we've actually seen Morrisons on. We found a lot of bumblebee species, but when you finally find the one that you're targeting, I don't know, it just makes all the difference. It's also fun finding all the ones that aren't your study species. I mean, it's just showing that even if the Morrison isn't here, it's still good habitat for bumblebees.
We are collecting pollen off of the Morrison leg, and we will send this to a lab. We're learning about other plants that we can't see them collecting pollen from that they're utilizing right now.
The data that's being collected on these surveys is so valuable for the future of bumblebees. The coolest thing about bumblebee conservation is that everyone can have an impact. Every day, more and more people are volunteering on surveys, they're using less pesticides, and they're planting pollinator-friendly plants in their yard. The next time you see a bumblebee, I hope that you get as excited as I do.